So India, my friend, my brother, Tirumurti is up.
I thank the chair of the Peace Building Commission, Ambassador Bob Rae, for organizing this very important meeting. I also take this opportunity to thank all briefers, particularly my friend, the Honorable Foreign Minister of The Gambia, His Excellency Mamadou Tangara, and also the Honorable Minister of Justice of The Gambia, His Excellency Mr. Daouda Diallo. India deeply appreciates the steady progress being made by The Gambia in the last 3.5 years, despite challenges posed by COVID-19 this year. The gains made in nurturing democracy, reform, the political process, peace and reconciliation, and economic growth need to be acknowledged and sustained. In the context of the negative impact of COVID-19, continuing support of the Peace Building Commission and the international partners will be essential. India recognizes the primacy of national governments in driving priorities for sustained peace at all stages of conflict, and that inclusivity is the key to advancing national peace-building objectives. Mr. Chair, I had the privilege to visit the smiling coast of Africa in July 2019 while accompanying the Honorable President of India on his first ever visit to The Gambia. We had also welcomed the visit of the Honorable Foreign Minister of Gambia in March last year. We welcome the commitment of the government of The Gambia in their march on the path of democratic governance and reform and in their political process. India has, in keeping with the priorities of The Gambia, extended development partnership and support for social and economic reform and progress. India has provided concessional lines of credit of US$78 million to support various projects, including the National Assembly Complex in Banjul. Another line of credit of US$92 million has been extended for infrastructure development. India has extended assistance from the India-UN Development Partnership Fund to implement a project on the using of drones and early warning system for pre and post-floods disaster management. We have set up a vocational training center and incubation center in Banjul. Each year, young Gambians travel to India for education, for skilling, and for navigating the digital world. India's flagship Indian Technical and Economic Cooperation Program and other scholarship programs attract more than 100 participants each year. India has also implemented the EVBAP network project, another flagship e-learning project for Africa. This year, several Gambian students have been given scholarships and are attending the virtual online graduates program offered by prestigious Indian educational institutions, a solution which has found resonance in the time of COVID. In June 2019, India hosted 25 permanent secretaries and senior civil servants at our National Center for Good Governance. We hosted a delegation of the Gambian Civil Service Commission in December last year. We also organized a special training program for 20 Gambian diplomats in 2018. Earlier this year, India extended support to the Gambia in its fight against COVID pandemic by supplying essential medicines. We have also responded positively to the request for debt restructuring. Mr. Chairman, let me reiterate that India remains committed to partner the Gambia. We look forward to a continued friendship and partnership and wish the Gambia well in their political process. Thank you very much.